Welcome to the Grace Cup Ministry. This is the day that the Lord hath made. Rejoice and be glad in it. I don't know about you, but I'm glad to be here today.
Hallelujah.
And today we have with us Pastor David Williams.
Thank you.
And he's with Fellowship of the Remnant Church,
yes.
Cleveland, Ohio. Let's welcome him.
Amen.
And Lorene Alexander in song. Let us have prayer. The Reverend Ella McDonald, Kingdom Building Ministries.
Let us pray. Father God, as again we come, we thank you for grace and mercy today.
Thank you, Lord.
Father, we thank you for your son, Jesus, who gave his life on Calvary Cross. And we thank you for salvation today.
Thank you,
Father,
Jesus.
God, we come again. Thank you for this ministry. Father, we ask your blessing as it goes out over the airway today, oh God,
yes,
that somebody might hear a word from you. Father, we ask you to bless the sick and the afflicted today, God.
Yes.
We ask you to bless those that are nursing home, convalescing home, Lord.
Yes.
Whatever they're going through today, Lord,
yes, Lord,
let them just to remember, just to call on your name, Lord.
Yes.
Father, your word said, though, that call on your name, Lord, shall be saved.
Yes.
So we thank you for that today, Lord. We thank you. Just give them peace today, oh God.
Peace.
We ask him for peace that passes
you,
all
Lord.
Understanding.
Peace.
Father, we thank you for what you're going to do on this program today. Father, we ask you to bless the man of God as the word come
touch
forth,
him,
that
Lord.
Somebody
yes.
might hear a word that will lift
thank
them up,
you,
and they
thank
will
you,
give their life to you.
Yes.
Father, we thank you and we bless your name. In the precious, mighty name of Jesus, we pray. Amen and thank God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
In the name
Amen.
Of
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. He's a mighty God.
Hallelujah.
Isn't it wonderful to be able to go before the throne of grace?
Hallelujah.
Isn't it just wonderful that he allows us to do that?
Amen.
Now turn to Matthew 25. And the 21st verse. And I'm here to let you know that Jesus is soon to return.
Amen.
Yes, yes.
And when he comes, we all want to hear him say, well done.
Amen.
Well done, thou great and faithful servant.
Yes.
Yes.
Well done. And that is Matthew 25 and 21. And I'm going to encourage you to read the entire chapter yourself. And it says, his Lord said unto him, mm-hmm. well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things.
Mm-hmm.
Enter thou into joy, into the joy of thy Lord. And we all want to hear him say, well done,
Amen.
Thou good and faithful servant.
Yes.
And Lorene Alexander will sing, well done.
Amen.
And after the song, you will hear from Pastor Williams. And after that, you will hear from Pastor and the Remnant. God bless you.
If when you give the best of your service, telling the world that the Savior is come. Be not dismayed when men don't believe you. He'll understand. He'll say, well done. Misunderstood, the Savior of sinners hung on the cross. He was God's only Son. Oh, hear him calling his Father in heaven. Not my will, but thine be done. Oh, when I come to the end of my journey, wearied of life and the battle has been won, carrying the staff at the cross of redemption, he'll understand and say, well done. But if you try and fail in your trials, and so in scar from the work you be gone, take up your cross, run swiftly to meet him. He'll understand, he'll say, well done. And oh, when I come to the end of my journey, carrying the staff at the cross of redemption, he'll understand. He'll say, well done.
Amen. Praise the Lord, saints. Thank you for tuning in to Grace Cup Ministries today. It is an honor to be here once again. Hello, my name is Pastor David Williams of the Fellowship of the Remnant. Again, we just extend honor to Sister Johnson and the Grace Cup Ministries. We thank her for the opportunity for us to come on this show and to share the word of God. Well, there is a word of God here this afternoon. And what I would like to do more than anything is to encourage the people. Right now, a lot of people are hurting. A lot of people without hope. A lot of people are without strength. They've grown weary over the battle. But today, the word of God is coming to encourage you. The word of God is coming to give, to put tools in your hand that you may be able to stand if you've knocked down, that you may be encouraged if you're discouraged. Whatever the case is, the word has come to encourage you. So turn in your Bibles to St. Mark, chapter 11, verses 23 and 24. That's where the text will be taken from. This is where I'll launch from. Again, just to encourage your hearts. I pray that you hear. He that hath an ear, let him hear. I pray you listen with your heart. Don't just read the words, but listen to the words and hear what the Spirit of God has to say. St. Mark chapter 11, verses 23 and 24. And this is the reading of God's word. For surely I say to you, whoever says to this mountain, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believe that those things he says will be done, he will have whatever he says. Therefore, I say to you, whatever things you ask when you pray, believe that you receive them and you will have them. Amen. Just a brief topic here, just a topic for this sermon. It's simple. Speak to your mountain. Speak to your mountain. Well, in these last days and in this hour right now, there's a lot of turmoil. There's a lot of hurt. There's a lot of pain that's going on in many people's lives. as we look at the text, I just want you to interject for the word mountains, difficulties. So when you see mountains, interject difficulties or hardships. So it says, for surely I say to you, whoever says to their hardship or to their difficulty, be removed and be cast into the sea, and does not doubt in his heart, but believes in those things, he will be done. There is a certain level of responsibility that I want to talk about here first. A lot of people are going to the pastor, trying to get the pastor to do everything for them. They want the pastor to pray. That's good. They want the pastor to work things out. They want other people to work them out. But there's a certain amount of responsibility that we have to have. Even people going to the Lord, they run into the Lord and want the Lord to work it out. I know he will. But when you look at this text, there's a certain amount of responsibility that we must walk in. Oftentimes, we go to God with the mountain. We go to God about the hardship. We go to God about what seems impossible. But in this text, God is telling us it's up to us to speak to the mountain. He didn't say speak at it. He said speak to it. He didn't say go around it. He said speak to it. Saints of God, right now, you can do something about your issues. You can do something about your problems. But it's going to take your faith. That's the only way you're going to come out of this thing. You've got to have faith. You've got to believe in it. I don't know about you, but coming up, as I prayed, there was oftentimes that I would pray my prayers before I went to bed as a child. I would lay me down to sleep. Y'all know the prayer. Amen. And we would pray. But over time, that became a very rote prayer. It became a prayer out of tradition. There's a difference right there. Even as we begin to pray for our food, Lord, bless my food for the nourishment of my body. Sometimes our prayer can become traditional. But in your situation right now, you don't need a traditional prayer. You need a prayer laden with faith. Do you believe that God can bring you out? Do you believe what the word says about the situation? Right now, I'm asking you right now to trust God and trust in his word. He said to ask. He said, if we ask and don't doubt, we can have it. Right now, I know you're looking at some hard situations. And right now, you don't believe that God's going to do it. Right now, there are some right now, you believe that God, everything is going to fail. You believe that they're going to come get the car, they're going to come get the house. You believe that the divorce is going to happen. You believe that people are going to continue to trip on you. You believe all these things. But when are you going to trust God? God has got the last say-so on everything that you're going through right now. It's time to trust God. One of the next thing I want to just say real quick, oftentimes as we're going through hardships, we blame other people. We get caught up in the blame game. I would be much further in life if my sister didn't do this to me. I would be much further in life if my daddy didn't do this to me. I would be much further in life if they didn't tell on me or they didn't do this. We got all of these blames and we're blaming people for our own demise. But when are we going to trust God? We have to take responsibility for our actions. Some of us are in situations because we did it. Tell the truth. You made the decision to do it. You made the decision to step out the will of God. You made the decision to walk away from God. You made the decision. It's not until you come to the point of recognize I did it, I was wrong, it was me. It was, in fact, I hear that old song, it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. It's not until you come to face with God and your situation that your situation will turn around. Some people, you know, right now, you're hurting and you feel like you're without strength. What are the words that you're speaking out of your mouth? The Bible clearly says that that tongue has power. It's the power of life and death. And right now, I know it looks like God is not going to come through. It looked like all hell's breaking loose. It looked like everything is going to be destroyed. But what are you speaking out of your mouth? Are you speaking, it ain't gonna happen? Are you speaking that God doesn't love me? Are you speaking just crazy things? Are you speaking that I don't believe it's gonna happen? You believe it's gonna fail. What are you speaking? You could be speaking your own demise. But the Bible says faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of the Lord. Right now, in your point right now, instead of speaking, if you can't speak nothing positive, be quiet. What you need to do is get into the word of God. You need to read the word. And what does the word say about your situation? The Bible said that I can do all things but fail. God promised that you are the head and not the tail. What are you listening to? And then you got to speak it. You got to hear the word and you got to speak it. Stop speaking defeated, defeatedism. Stop speaking like God is not going to work. In fact, God is waiting on your faith. Whatever the mountain is right now, it's time to face it. Whatever the difficulty it is, it's time to face it. It's time for some practical application. Right now, if you're viewing this from the hospital bed, right now, if you're viewing this from home and you just got a bad report from the doctor, there's another doctor that you need to talk to. I know there's a doctor on staff at the hospital, but there's another doctor you need to talk to. You need to go to him about the situation. Why do I need to go to him? Because I told you before, he's got the last say so. In fact, this doctor's so good that he paid a price for your healing. The Bible says that by your stripes, you're healed. So right now, if you're dealing with cancer right now, what I want you to do is go get you some oil. Right now, if you're dealing with a sickness of diabetes and high blood pressure, what I want you to do is go get some more. If you can't get no oil, that's all right. But what I want you to do, don't run to the pastor. Don't run. I want you to lay hands on yourself right now. What I want you to do is just start speaking to yourself that, God, I know what the doctor said, but I'm coming to you. But by your stripes, I'm healed. I want you to do is speak to that mountain. Speak to it with the word of God. Don't speak with worry. Don't speak with frustration, but speak to that mountain right now. He's a healer. He's a deliverer. I know you done tried the medicine, but what I'm trying to dare tell you is try the Lord. There was a woman with the issue of blood. She was suffering for many years. And the Bible says that she spent everything she had. And finally, she had heard about Jesus coming to town. And Jesus came to town and she recognized. Y'all know the story. If you don't know the story, she was considered unclean. She had an issue of blood, so she bled profusely. She was weak, but she heard Jesus was coming. She didn't have nothing. I'm speaking to somebody right now. You right now, you figure, I ain't got no health insurance. I ain't got no money. Right now, you ain't got no transportation. But do you have Jesus? And as long as you got Jesus, you got everything you need to be healed. The Bible says that he is the God that healeth and bindeth up the wound. I'm talking to you right now. I'm trying to encourage you. Don't believe the enemy's report. The devil wants to kill you. The devil wants to steal your health. But I'm telling you right now, Jesus came that you may have life and life more abundantly. And this woman here, she came to him and she couldn't get to him. It was very crowded. She couldn't get up to him from up top because it was crowded. So the Bible says is that she went low. And she began to crawl on the ground to get to Jesus. There's some people right now, you want everything easy, but there comes a time where you got to get low. There comes a time where you got to do some strange things to get to the Lord. But that's what it takes to get to him, and that's what you got to do. Sometimes you got to get dirty to get to Jesus. Sometimes you got to labor in prayer all day and all night. Sometimes you got to give up something to get to him. But whatever it takes to get to the garment, that's what it takes. That's what I got to do. I'm encouraging you. It takes a fight to overcome obstacles. But he said, speak to it. Speak to the mountain. Mama, you having a problem with them kids. I understand that sometimes in some situations, daddy ain't there. But mama, it's still, you got the responsibility. I know it's hard. I know it's rough. But baby, I'm going to tell you right now, get every one of them, pull them in the front room, pull them in your bedroom, regather them, pull them all together and hug on them and say, man, you going to be something, Junior. You going to be something, daughter. You going to be something. You will succeed. You will win. Start speaking to the mountain. Speak to it with the word of God. God will be a father to the father. God promised that he'll be a mother to the mother. So whatever you need, mama, God is right there. But you got to trust him. You got to believe him. Speak to the mountain. Right now, there's people's jobs that are being closed up. I know I'm talking to somebody because it's happening widespread. People are hurting right now, and they don't know where to turn to. I'm trying to turn you back to the Lord. I'm trying to tell you right now, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Trust him. He's right there. But you've got to speak to the mountain. Oh, but what happens when the mountain speaks back? What do you do when the mountain speaks back? You go to put a job and they say, we still ain't going to hire you. You go and you try to get medicine. You try to get help. They tell me, well, you know what? We can't find the diagnosis. What happens when the mountain speaks back? What happens you try to get a situation straight with a loved one and they turn their back on you? They still cut you out and they still dog you. But what I'm going to say, still speak to the mountain. Some mountains ain't going to go away overnight. Some mountains, you got to continue to speak to it. You got to speak to it today, tomorrow, next week, next month. Some mountains you got to speak to, but whatever you do, don't stop speaking. Don't stop prophesying. Can these dead bones live? That's the question. That's the question, but there's an answer. They can. God told the prophet to open up your mouth and speak to the dead bones. That's what God is telling. Whatever dead in your life, speak to it. Speak to it. Because the word, God is waiting for his word to go forth. And see, watch the practicality of it. When the word goes forth, the Holy Spirit is waiting to back it up. Just waiting to validate it. See, you got to speak those things, though it be not, but speak it as it is. I know you're weak, but you need to say, you know what? I'm strong. I'm strong right now. I'm strong in the Lord right now. I know you don't have much in money right now, but you say, I am rich. I am rich in the Lord. That's what you got to do. You got to see your situation as God sees it. Speak to your mountain. There's some situations you can't speak to it directly, but you know how to go in your secret closet. There's some people in certain situations you can't deal with it directly because they don't want to talk to you. But I dare you to go in your closet and still give God the glory. I dare you to go in your closet and give God praise. Don't you know that praise is a form of warfare? Don't you know that when you praise God, when praises go up, blessings come down? Don't you know you got to fight the devil different kind of ways? And one of the ways you got to fight him is through praise. It's in worship. Giving him glory. Giving him praise. One thing about the devil, you got to understand, sometimes he's relentless, amen. But sometimes you got to get relentless with your praise. I know things don't look good, but you know what? I'm still going to praise you. I'm still going to magnify you. I'm still going to lift up holy hands. God, I'm still going to give you glory. Why? Because I believe you. I trust you. I don't know how you're going to do it. I just know you're going to do it. I don't know when you're going to do it. But I believe that you're going. Some folk ain't much to trust in no more right now. Look like all the doors have closed. But why are you looking for the door and you got a door? That's the problem. You're looking for the door to come through people. You're looking for the door to come. But Jesus said, I am the door. See, that's my point right there. When you get to Jesus, you got to the door. And when God opens up the door, can't nobody close it. When God opens up windows, can't nobody close it. Get to Jesus. Scoundering. You're looking for these different ways and you're looking for these different avenues. But Jesus say, I am the way. Do y'all see what I'm saying here? He is the way. You tired of being deceived? You're looking for truth? He said he is the truth. So he's the truth. He's the way, the truth, and the life. And no man can come unto the Father. But it's going to take an act of your faith. Look at what the scripture says. It says that when you look at verse 20, the latter part, 23, he said, and does not doubt in your heart, but believe those things he says he will be done. He will have whatever. See, some of you, you're speaking negativity, and you're receiving everything that you're speaking. That's why your life hasn't changed, because you're still speaking things that are death. You're speaking curses. You're speaking negativity. You're speaking things of, that's why you're in a situation. But when you speak the words of life, change will happen. And he said, therefore, here's another thing I love about what Jesus is doing. He's preparing the disciples, because he knew obstacles were going to come. He knew hardships were going to come. I just want to talk to that person right now. The story ain't over. No, the story ain't over. I know we got a little bad couple paragraphs in your life right now. I know all hell is breaking, but the story ain't ever over. He who's begun a good work shall finish it unto the day of redemption. So what, things are going bad? So what, people are tripping? But if you just hold on, God's going to finish the story. And when God finishes the story, look at, everything's going to be all right. Why do I know that? Because He promised all things work together for the good of them that love Him and call Him. He's not finished. Now watch this, how He works this. It may not feel good while it's working, but you got to know that it's working for my good. Anybody that's spiritual, anybody that's anything in God will tell you that they were mostly blessed by their hardships, because it was through their hardships they learned how to pray. It was through their hardships that they fasted. It was in their hardships they learned how to lean on God. It was through their hardships they found the heart of God. And they found out how to rely on Him. They found out how to trust Him. It wasn't when the bank account was filled with money. It wasn't when the health was perfect. It wasn't when everybody was liking them. It was in the times that hardships, that they were shaping and they were developed in the Lord. Those who are looking right now, I got to give you this promise. If you're none of His, I'm sorry. When you pray, I'm sorry, you can't get it that way. You have to be His. You have to be His. So right now, if you don't know the Lord as your Lord and Savior, let's pray. Father God, we thank You for the opportunity, Lord. There's a mountain in my life, but I recognize I have to be Yours, so that when I speak Your word, it will come to pass. Now, Father, I pray that the people who are looking at this broadcast, that they will run right now to You. They'll find a church home. They will find somebody that knows the Lord. They will give their life to You. Now, God, we believe You to do it. In Jesus' name, amen.